Buy my shirts, buy my hats, buy it all.
Come watch me stream, yeah.
Oh, it's gonna be one of these videos, guys. Buckle up. Hey everybody, what's up? If you're new to my channel, my name is Chris Clemens, or if you're one of my Clementines, welcome back to the dysfunction that is my channel. Also, welcome back to probably a video I will most likely regret uploading, but this is real and this is me. Oh guys, I don't even remember when. I think it was at some point during quarantine, but I uploaded a video of things I bought high where I went around my house and I showed you guys things I bought stoned. Pretty self-explanatory. Because I'm always trying to relive the glory days, I was thinking,
what's a similar video I can do?
And then I was like, Chris, dumb bitch, baby girl, you've been in a 6 month long mental breakdown. You have bought so much shit trying to put a band-aid over that gaping hole. I don't really remember what I was talking about. I really got hung up on the phrase gaping hole. Regardless, I am definitely somebody who, embarrassingly enough, I believe in the church of retail therapy heavily. I hope to God this doesn't come across as a house tour, because if you guys want one, I will do that later when, you know, things are done. But I figured this would be a fun way to write off everything I've bought from 2020's taxes. Thank you, and good night. Now before we get into the video, as you guys know, I dedicate my videos to different organizations, causes, small businesses, etc. Surprise, I'm doing it again. I wanna dedicate this video not only to teachers' Amazon wish lists to help complete their classrooms, but also to the Louisville Bail Fund. I'm sure by the time this video is going up, you have heard about the verdict of Breonna Taylor's case, and it is just simply insane. A ton of people in Louisville specifically who are protesting that verdict are getting arrested and charged. You know who's not? The cops. But because of that, I want to put the Louisville Bail Fund down below. People should not be getting arrested and charged for stating their First Amendment right, executing their First Amendment right. Words are a great difficulty today. But you know what's not a great difficulty today? Using the sponsor of this video, which is Harry's. Thank you, Harry's, for sponsoring this video. Was that a seamless transition? If you guys don't know the brand Harry's, they are an incredible shaving company. I've talked about this before, but buying razors has always been so confusing to me. I have never known which one is right, which one is good, which one isn't gonna make me have a whole bunch of red dots under my neck. And Harry's really makes it so simple with affordable products that actually give you a close, nice, comfortable shave. They sent me this starter kit, which is literally anything you could need. It comes with amazing Harry's shave gel with aloe, a fully weighted razor with a textured grip, and a 5-blade cartridge, which gives you the most impeccable shave, by the way. And lastly, in the starter set, they include a razor head guard, which I can't even tell you how key this is when you're traveling.
This is me shaving. I know, so sexy. I'm using the starter set and I literally love these razors. Like, I truly do. The shave, I don't know how to describe it. It's just like, you feel the difference in the blades. I really do love that Harry's is so affordable with refills starting only at $2. And they came out with their sharpest blades ever and they didn't even raise the price. They're still as low as $2. Like, oh my God.
Harry's also has really great products like body wash, which I know some of you guys watching stink. So, if you want everything you will ever need for a close, comfortable shave, go to harrys.com/chrisclemens and get your trial set for just $3. So, go be sure to hit that link in my description. Again, harrys.com/chrisclemens. And now, let's go look at other... Ow, I just bit my fucking tongue off. Anyway, let's look at all the other stuff I've bought in a mental breakdown, because there's a lot. Welcome to my bedroom. I don't even know where to start now that I'm being perfectly honest. There is just so much shit I have bought in a mental breakdown. It's more almost like, what did I not buy in a mental breakdown, you know? Anyways, there is really no rhyme or reason to anything I've bought. One thing I've been very into is vintage furniture shopping. I found a place where I can do curbside pickups. Yeah, game changer. But something this vintage furniture store place has like a ton of are these fucking little stools. I don't even understand them, but I'm obsessed with them.
No, I don't think you understand. I'm obsessed.
I've really been into like little accents throughout the house, and I love these benches that you can put shit on. I've also bought some crystals. I don't know what they are, but I bought them because I'm trying.
anything.
I've also been really into these Palo Santo sticks. They smell bomb and I think they look pretty as well.
This is bad. This has already been like 10 minutes in a corner.
I also bought fake foliage because there's no way I'd be able to keep a real plant alive in this bedroom. Hello, fake plant number one. Next up, I bought this from Crate and Barrel, and it's literally just a bigger container of water so I can pour it in a smaller container of water. Truly, the best however many dollars I've spent. This did do a lot of serotonin for me. Now we are at my dresser. I have bought, oh my god, this is really fucking heavy. Next up, I bought this marble box from CB2 and I'm obsessed. This still gives me so much serotonin every time I open it, which as the days continue, becomes more and more frequent. But this is my marijuana box. I can't really show much of it on YouTube, but I have pre-rolls, edibles, kind of anything marijuana related. It's so nice to just have a place that also keeps it smell proof, and I just banged my camera. Further down on the dresser, we have more Palo Santo sticks. Oh my god, I had a mental breakdown. Yeah, bitch, welcome. From the same vintage furniture store, I found this ashtray, which I'm
obsessed with.
I'm not gonna throw in the audio for every time I say I'm obsessed. I'm just gonna say the word obsessed a ton. Ashtrays are definitely something I not only love collecting, but love having. There's just something about having an ashtray that's unique in every room that isn't your standard one. Isn't this fun? Hey guys, next up I'm sitting on this bench, which was originally meant for my studio, but it was too big and I am too lazy, so I just put it at the end of my bed with an anxiety blanket that I also bought in a mental breakdown. Here we have two more gorgeous stools. I wasn't kidding when I said I loved stools. I have this one, which I don't even think you can sit on. Iconic, gorgeous, stunning. And then this stool, I already have one actually here that I bought, and then I wanted to buy the other one so that nobody else could. Holy fuck, I am like obsessed with this stool. Absolutely
obsessed.
And I just think it looks so nice. Anyway, I'm not gonna get into it. You'll see later why I buy these things. Next up, we have these like wooden pots or vases. How fucking cool are these? Oh my god. I'm excited to like really think about the nitty gritty of decorating. So I have a lot of these because they're great. I need to stop fucking saying obsessed. Next up, at the same vintage furniture store, I found this painting. Huh? I would never be able to paint something like this, and I think it is stunning. I used to have a giant painting up on that wall. If you follow me on Instagram, I posted that a ton. But I took that down and I moved it to a different place, but I want to put this along with some other frames, maybe such as these, which I, you guessed it, also bought at the same vintage furniture store. I literally have paid this vintage furniture store's mortgage. Has this helped my mental health? I would say yeah, like hard yeah. We're over at my bedside table and I have bought a ton of these Torch Los Angeles candles. They are a black owned and I think female owned candle company. They make the best smelling candles. This is the black bamboo scent. I almost said flavor. I'm cultured. Now we're working into my closet, which is where a lot of the serotonin was like supposed to be flowing from. I don't think as much came from it as I thought it would. One day, I thought I was gonna get a lot of dopamine from buying new glassware. So what did I do? So I bought 8 versions of this wine glass, 8 versions of another wine glass, like 32 cups, and then these mugs because I think they're gorgeous. Did they do something? Honestly, the most they did is make me a wineaholic. I also bought a kettle and this tea box full of tea. I was going through a phase of loving to have a hot cup of tea before bed, and then that lasted a week. But needless to say, I've been getting back into the tea game, just not as fast as I was hoping. The next thing I bought are these pair of Loewe loafers. I am obsessed with these. I love these because I've never really been a loafer person, but I saw these because I love the brand, and if you want to wear them as loafers, you can, but if you want to wear them as slides, the back bends down.
Obsessed.
I have spent so much. No, we've been in quarantine a long time. Never mind. Next up, we have these colored lights up behind my mirror, and I have some behind my dresser. Love some nights being able to switch between the two, have some purple and some red, create a really romantic vibe for a party of one. I am so in need of human contact in a very sexual way. In my bathroom, I don't know why, but I bought a lot of towels, and that's all I bought for my bathroom. Like I said, I bought a lot of torch candles. Was not kidding. Let's go. Next, we have the Middle Kid Studio, which I am Middle Kid stoked about. I bought a lot for my streaming setup. Wow, the soundproofing in here has done nothing. Oh my gosh, these soundproofing boards I bought. That was mostly for work. Did it help with the mental breakdown? No. because there's still echoes.
But oh my god, a huge fucking breakthrough. Stream it.
I, as you guys know, streamed on Twitch at the beginning of quarantine, stopped when we moved, never got it set up. I bought a whole new computer for it. The Twitch link is down below, and if you connect your Amazon Prime to your Twitch account, you get a free subscription every month that you can use on me. Boom. But I've been live streaming a ton, and let me tell you, spending $2,000 on a laptop has never given me so much excitement in my life. Anyways, Chris, that was a little strong. Here we have another ashtray. A lot of my joints fall into it, but it's stunning and I love it. I also bought this easel, which I am currently working on a piece for our living room. And along with this easel, I have bought truly so much painting supplies. Oh my god, and these shelves. Oh my god, these shelves. There's an Instagram I follow, Easton House. Incredible. He is incredible and has amazing furniture taste. Anyways, a store that I loved and really kind of opened my mind up to fashion was Opening Ceremony. If you don't know, it's a store that's now closed, but they had like the coolest store design. These shelves existed in the Los Angeles store and he bought them and sold them to me. And I'm like, I just love them. So these shelves get me so excited every time I see them. So thanks for that one. Shelves. But like I was saying, I bought a bunch of paints, canvases. I have some finished canvases down here. It's just like a fun, creative room. This room really actually helps a lot with my mental breakdown. Yeah, baby! Oh, another thing is I fully have a chair obsession. So I bought this chair. Is it not gorgeous? So sometimes I paint in here. Sometimes I stream on here. Most of the time I literally just stare at it in appreciation. Another thing I bought is this fake plant. I am a big believer in having real plants, but also mixing real plants with fake plants throughout the house so nobody really knows what the fuck is going on. Serotonin achieved. After leaving the studio and on the way to my office, I have this hanging in the hallway, which I might move to a more public area of the house. But I bought this from an artist named Trouble Andrew and he did the Gucci Ghost logo for Gucci. When the BLM movement really picked up speed after George Floyd, this artist did a 100. Oh my god, only 100. Look at that. Look at that. More serotonin. Did I expect it? Not at all. I thought that this was honestly such a great investment and just a great piece of art to have in the house. And I got number 65 out of 100, so love that. Next up, we are moving into my office, which I have a lot of shit in here that I have bought really trying to cure something called depression. As we can see from my couch, I've bought a lot of picture frames as I am trying to really make this feel homey. I also bought this brass dog from a vintage furniture store. I don't know, I love it though. Oh, and here we have a Torch Los Angeles candle again. Next up, ow, there's a fucking picture frame up my butthole. Next up, we have these three skateboards, which were done by the artist Noah Barker, or nbarker00 on Instagram. He actually made a custom skateboard of Andrew, of a picture Andrew posted on Instagram. I loved his work so much that I hit him up and had him do a three-piece skateboard. I've had these for probably a month and just have ignored mounting them because it feels like so much work. They were originally gonna go in here, and now the office is filling up nicely, so I'm not really sure. Guys, next up we have literally maybe the thing that gives me the most joy in my day, what I imagine having a kid feeling like. It's this natal fig tree. I bought this at a nursery. I saw it, it's such a unique looking tree, and I love how the branches kind of just go any fucking way. This really did a lot, and it got delivered to me from the nursery. I didn't have to put it in my car. Serotonin overflow. Next up I have more crystals, and I bought a printer. I also bought this picture frame, I think from World Market. It was $35. All right, I feel like that's everything in my office. Let's go to the main rooms. All right, guys, we're in the living room now, and this is pretty much all been one giant depression purchase. I mean that totally genuinely. Here is another one of these stools I bought, and it works perfectly as a side table. I mean, like, I don't even need to explain why this looks good, because it just looks good. I bought this fake tree from Etsy, and I have to say it literally looks like a fake tree. I don't know why olives would be growing in my living room, but I need to remove almost all of them. This could not have looked more different online than when I opened the box it came in and my jaw hit the cement. Because this is a fake plant, I stuffed a majority of this with just like literally cardboard. And then I bought moss and put it on top so it has a chance of looking like a real tree. This couch means so much to me and I'm not gonna go into it because I don't think literally a single person cares. You guys might recognize this rug from my old bedroom. I got another rug at the same vintage furniture store. I really like the green, but it
felt like a lot of green, so we put this rug on top of it, and I really love how it turned out. Oh my gosh, and right next to me is another ashtray. Guys, where in the hell would you ever find an ashtray like this? This was like $30. I love this. I love that it matches our table, and yeah.
Obsessed.
Oh my god, guys, this is the stool. This is like why I love this. It's such a nice accent next to this couch. I want to get obviously more to put on here, but I love this fake succulent I have, and just it creates such a nice, like, homey vibe. Like, oh, hi, little stool. Yeah, no, I fully hear myself. Just, I'm aware. But like I said, mental breakdown. Like I've said for the 100th time, I've really been into small little details and accents. I got this at World Market. I got this at the vintage furniture store. I spread this one apart, put it together. Never have to fucking water it. That's how I imagine having kids is being like, just like, here's some food, water. See you in 8 hours. Anyways, that's why I'm fully not a parent. This table is also from Easton House, and I, once again, am obsessed. I then found this ashtray at the vintage furniture store, which, again, do I need to go into detail? We're winding down here. Oh my gosh, guys, these are the cups I mentioned earlier that I bought like 110 of. So this is the painting I bought from another vintage furniture store, and the one that I was telling you was in my bedroom. Anyways, moving on, speaking of buying glassware in bulk, I bought this thing for wine, used it maybe twice. It looks gorgeous though. It is like definitely a vibe when red wine's in here and you're just like, hey. Anyways. Last and certainly not least, I bought the Chrissy Teigen Cravings 12-piece cookware set. In all actuality, that is why I bought it. I was like, why the fuck not? I've never bought a new set of pots or pans ever. I've only used these two so far, and they have been incredible pans? Pots? What are these? Pans? Pans. Frying pans. What's the difference?
Those are pans.
Pans? Okay, cool. For real though, these are really good, and I'm excited to have pans that I care about. And yeah, that is everything I have bought in my mental breakdown. Probably not everything, not even close, but it's everything that I feel comfortable sharing. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Feel free to tell me how many times in the comments I said the word obsessed. Dying to hear that or vintage furniture store. I realize how fucking Caucasian I sound. I'm aware. For real though, thank you guys for tuning in to another video. Be sure to subscribe to me on Twitch as I am constantly streaming. Also, thank you to Harry's for subscribing to this, for sponsoring this. I'm broken. So broken. Scene. I need a good night of sleep. Thank you.